Psalm 132 verse 17. God's word is a lamp through this dark world. Psalm 132:17. There I will cause the horn of David to spring forth. I have prepared a lamp for mine anointed. The horn can be a symbol of several things, but all of which speak of power. It can be a dynamic announcement or a call to battle. In either case, it is an attention-getting device. The psalmist writes that the promise of David's lineage will spring forth, culminating in the advent of the Messiah, the King of Kings. In Luke 1:68-69, John the Baptizer's father, Zechariah, quotes Psalm 18:2, understanding its application to the one who is about to be born, the Messiah. Praise the Lord, the God of Israel, because he has visited and provided redemption for his people. 69. He has raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. In 2 Samuel 21:15-18, we read, the Philistines again waged war against Israel. David went down with his soldiers, and they fought the Philistines, but David became exhausted. 16. Then Yishbo ben Ob, one of the descendants of the giant, whose bronze spear weighed about 8 pounds and who wore new armor, intended to kill David. 17. But Abishai son of Zeruiah came to his aid, struck the Philistine, and killed him. Then David's men swore to him, you must never again go out with us to battle. You must not extinguish the lamp of Israel. 18. After this, there was another battle with the Philistines at Gob. The unfounded fear of David's men was, should he have been killed in a battle, the kingly line of Israel would be cut off and the Messiah would not come, but God's plan is not dependent on the wiles of men. God's word is a light by which all Christians can walk, David records in Psalm 119:105. Your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. HCSB. Now this may be one of those verses that you have heard all your life. Its application is to each of us, and we should use the word of God personally, practically, and habitually as we make our way through this sin-darkened world. Worldly wisdom says, when in Rome, do as Romans do. But this is not wisdom from heaven, where we who are born anew Christians hold our citizenship. God's Spirit through Paul in the Epistle to the Philippians 3:17-21, writes, brethren, join in following my example and note those who so walk, as you have us for a pattern. 18. For many walks of whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ. 19. Whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who set their mind on earthly things. 20. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. 21. Who will transform our lowly body so that it may be conformed to his glorious body, according to the working by which he is able, even able to subdue all things to himself. Even though we are making our journey through the cities of this world, and we are often called to work within its systems of darkness, we must never venture there without the lamp of the word, for fear that we may slip. Each redeemed person should use the word of God personally, practically, and habitually, that he may see his way through the darkness by the light of God's holy word. This is a true picture of our path through this dark world as our minds are being renewed throughout our time here. We must forget the habits and ways of the world and learn to walk in the way of the Spirit. We read in Romans 8:1-2, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. 2. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death.